All right, welcome back in part one of our video on search engine optimization and .NET Nuke. We talked about things like using .NET Nuke out of the box, using things like your title tags, meta descriptions, and canonical URLs, some of the real basics. In this video, I want to talk about some of the things that you really need to do if you want your site to rank really good in the search engines. If you're in a competitive battle against your competition, for that top spot in Google. So let's go ahead and get started. All right. So out of the box, a couple of the problems that you have with .NET Nuke are the URLs. Now, I'm going to show you another website, and this is a website, that wasn't something that needed a ton of search engine optimization. But, this is a website for the Downtown Development District in Hammond, Louisiana. And some of the problems that are inherent with .NET Nuke are one of the major ones anyway, is duplicate content. You've got issues where the website will respond to multiple URLs. And I'm just going to go to the home page here. And you'll see, when I click on home, I've got ddd.hammond.com/home/tab-id/88/default.aspx. And, that's just a lot of garbage in the domain name. If I remove this out of here and just let it be ddd.hammond.com/default.aspx, then the home page also responds to that. So there's two pages that Google is seeing. And then if I go ddd.hammond.com/home, then the home page will also respond to that. Then I can also add the www in here. And I can do that with all of those different combinations. And then I can get rid of it and just have it as, ddd.hammond.com. So there's another one. So that's at least 8 different URLs that this website can respond to for just the home page. That's a major issue because the search engines, they don't want to see duplicate content. They want to see the content that is on the page of your website, being in only one place on the web. And it is kind of a controversial topic among, SEOs as to how much duplicate content hurts, but I will tell you that on my sites that we get in there and fix the duplicate content issues, the website starts ranking better. So in my opinion, this is a big deal. Now, if we go over to my website and look at it, it is also .NET Nuke, same platform that the DDD Hammond website was built on. And you'll notice that, like, if I remove the www and try to go to it, then my site is going to go to, www.fivestonesmedia.com. If I put in fivestonesmedia.com/home, it goes back to fivestonesmedia or www.fivestonesmedia.com. If I put in the default.aspx, then it goes back to fivestonesmedia.com. My home page of my website has one URL that it responds to and one only, and that is www.fivestonesmedia.com. The module that I use is a product called Ifinity URL Master, and there are a lot of different URL rewriters out there for .NET Nuke. I have used most of them, if not all of them, and this particular module is rock solid. It just works. It is easy to use. The other ones are very buggy. I have not used one yet that was not an absolute pain in the butt to use besides Ifinity. It is very easy to install to the site and set it up. There are a lot of different settings. I will put screenshots of the settings from my website in this blog so that if you decide to purchase this module, you can kind of use my settings as a guide to get started. And it does some really nice things. When I go back to the DDD website, for example, if I click on the About page, this is the URL that I get. This is dddhammond.com/about-DDD. That's all in caps. /tab-id/93/default.aspx. And that's just not a clean URL. It's not something that you can easily send someone to. Whereas if you go to my site and, you know, we go to the about page, it's simply fivestonesmedia.com/about. And you'll notice that the text on my page here is in all caps, but here it's in all lowercase. And that's because I've set it so that the URLs show up as all lowercase. The other nice thing about it is that you can get rid of the parent page in the URL structure. So like if I go to services and go to web design, then you'll see it's just fivestonesmedia.com/web-design. If I go to the DDD and click on a subpage, then I see that whole string, dddhammond.com/events/signature-events, and then the rest of it. So this is a nice way to really clean up your URLs. And the URL, you can set it to be anything that you want it to be. You can do redirects of your old URLs, which it'll do out of the box. Your old URLs will be redirected to the new URL. And just a really nice module. Now, you can choose to have it use the www or not. And there's really no benefit to using it or to not using it. It's just personal preference. I like to use the www because most of the time when people link to your site, they're going to include that. Now, whether they include it or not, if somebody follows that URL, it's going to take them to your site and it's going to work just fine. So whatever your personal preference is. Now, the other thing that you can do is on your blog, Ifinity URL Master has got a nice little add-on to use that gives you nice clean URLs for your blog. And you can set it up to where it has the category string or the date string in there if you want it. I preferred not to on mine, but it's another really good thing to do. So the things that we've talked about, if you use good title tags, good meta descriptions, if you have the URL master installed to your site and have it configured correctly, and you know, use the add-on for your blog, and then use canonical URLs as well, then you have a really solid platform there for doing some good SEO. There are a lot of other things that you can do, but this video was really about how to get the most out of .NET Nuke and search engine optimization. Some of the other things that you can do are, obviously you need to build really good content for your site. And that's really what I'm doing here. When I produce this video, when I produce this blog, the reason that I do that is because I'm producing good content for my website. And it's something, around our area of expertise. And it's something that the search engines will pick up on. So, you want your website to have really good, solid content on it. And it needs to, you want to have keywords in the content. But remember, always write for the reader. Don't write for the search engines. Always make sure that you're producing good, quality content. So there are some best practices that, you should follow. A really good resource for learning some of those best practices is a website called moz.com. And I am a pro member of moz.com, which they've got some outstanding tools for really seeing what's going on with your website. It'll give you error reports showing you issues like whether or not you have duplicate content, whether or not you have pages with missing title tags. And these are things that you wouldn't necessarily see just by clicking through your website. You may not know that a page has three different URLs that it responds to, but you can find that out when you're using a service like moz.com. It gives you on-page grades and things like that. But this is moz.com right here. They have a great blog, and this one particular blog, I will have the URL to it in the in my blog, and it's about how do I build the perfectly optimized page. And it kind of gives you a nice little layout where they show you a page and, you know, the things that you should do to it. And here's that layout, you know, talking about your H1 tags and, you know, bolding text and, you know, using, you know, ordered lists and stuff like that. So this is a really good resource, really good read. I suggest if you're serious about SEO, of course, to join Moz.com and use the tools that are available to you. If you've got any questions, feel free to ask them in the blog comments or on the YouTube video comments. You know, give us a like on YouTube, and really appreciate it. If you find, you know, that this is just, it's too much, and you're looking for someone to do some SEO for you on .NET Nuke, then, you know, I would absolutely love to have the opportunity to talk to you about doing that for you. Again, my name is Brian Walker with Five Stones Media, and if you've made it this far into the video, I appreciate you sticking with me, and I hope that you see some great value from it. Thank you.